Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. In the last video, we have set up Raspberry Pi as a web server using Docker and .NET web app, .NET Core web app. But only setting up the web app is not sufficient, as a web server not sufficient, we need a database also. My primary choice was SQL Server, but SQL Server is not supported on Raspberry Pi. However, Microsoft provides a Linux Docker image to install the SQL Server, but that is based on x86 architecture, while the Raspberry Pi is ARM-based architecture. I'm looking for an alternative. So the two alternatives I found, one is MySQL, that is supported on Raspberry Pi, and NoSQL, means MongoDB. MongoDB also supported on Raspberry Pi. In my career, I haven't used MongoDB so far, so thought, let's give it a try. And I created an application or designed the, and I will design the application this way that if the MongoDB is not suitable, then I can switch to other database just by plugin. MongoDB also, the current my operating system is Raspbian on Raspberry Pi, and MongoDB is not supported on Raspbian. MongoDB needs Ubuntu. I'm going to install the Ubuntu in this Raspberry Pi, install the MongoDB and set up on Raspberry Pi, and then set up a network environment so I can use it from my laptop, connect from my laptop on my development machine. So let's get started with the video now. First thing, we want to install Ubuntu on Raspberry Pi. We need micro SD card. We also need imager. So I'm using Raspberry Pi imager to get the image. So start the Raspberry Pi imager and select the OS. OS will be Ubuntu version 220, Ubuntu Server 21.0, and 64 ARM based OS. Select it. Then next step is select the media, write it down. It will take a couple of minutes, maybe 5 to 10 minutes to create the image. Once you return the image, don't do anything, remove the image and put it into Raspberry Pi. Boot the Raspberry Pi. It will ask for password. The password is Ubuntu, user is Ubuntu, password also Ubuntu, and it will ask to change the password. So we will give the new password and our Raspberry Pi ready to work. But still it is not connected to network. So two things we are going to do here. One, we are change the configuration to be able to connect to our Wi-Fi. And secondly, we will give it a static network IP address. So go to netplan, etc, netplan, and 50 dash, there's a file name. I'll give the file name on the screen. Open that file, go to network section. You will see Ethernet by default. You will not see the Wi-Fi. So we will add Wi-Fi section there, Wi-Fi's, and we'll provide our network related information. The details looks like as per I'm showing on the screen. That's how you have to set up your network. So we will provide our Wi-Fi address, we'll provide Wi-Fi name, password, and the network address we want to assign to this Raspberry Pi, which will remain static. Because once the Raspberry Pi is set up, we don't want it to be connected to the keyboard, or mouse. We want it to connect through our laptop. We will be doing the SSH to the laptop, or if we are using Windows, then we will put the an SSH into that server, into Raspberry Pi. Or if I have a Mac, I can directly do an SSH to the Raspberry Pi. So this is whole process. Now, in my case, because I had this cheap keyboard, so I connected, this is 300 rupees keyboard. So now once I modified my network file, and when I reboot my Raspberry Pi, my Raspberry Pi is ready to connect to internet, and from there our main process starts. So very simple step is, first we will run this upgrade commands in sudo apt-get update, sudo apt-get upgrade. Then this process, it will take 5 minutes complete. Once it is done, install the MongoDB. So MongoDB, there's a lot of, if you go to same article again, you'll see the URL. You can use that URL, set up, install the MongoDB on your machine. Now, once we downloaded the script, we will run this command sudo apt-get install -y MongoDB. It will install the version 4.40. We have to enable the MongoDB after that. And for that, we will use this following command sudo systemctl daemon reload, and then enable MongoDB and restart our services. Once it is done, if you want to check status, then we have a command this MongoDB sudo systemctl status MongoDB, and then it will tell you the status server is running. The next step, we will connect to MongoDB. So we have a command called mongo, and once we connect, it will give you the prompt. It will tell you server version prompt, and then our MongoDB almost ready. But we want to secure the MongoDB. It means you must have some user ID password to connect to the MongoDB. So the first thing we want to do is that we will use the admin. So we will use these commands to connect, create an admin user. We'll create the user ID and password, then we will give the role. Once it is done, the next part is go to MongoDB config file at etc MongoDB file, and go to security section. Authorization should be enabled, and then save this file and restart the service. When it's restarted, then when you connect without user ID password, and when we run any command like list database, this will not work and it will give you some error. So what we have to do, it will be unauthorized. So what we have to do, we have to use user ID password to connect to MongoDB. So mongo-u user ID, then password. Then if you try to list the database, and it will allow us to show all the database in the system. This is now Raspberry Pi is ready, but not complete. We want this Raspberry Pi to be able to access from network, and for that we need a little bit more configuration, and we have to go to etc mongodb.config and go to net section, net colon, and there we have a by default port is 27017. There is a bind IP. So by default, bind IP is 20 localhost, which is localhost, but we have to remove it and make it 000 and then restart the service again. Once it is done, restart the service. Run this command sudo ufw allow 27017 TCP. Now our server is ready. Now our MongoDB is ready. And what we can do now, go to our laptop, and from our laptop SSH into, you don't need to SSH now because we have a static IP, we have a MongoDB set up for the network connection. So we'll just run the command mongo. We must have a client installed on our machine from where we're connecting. So mongo then host means IP address of the host, -- host IP address, and then we will provide the user ID and password, admin and password, and now we are connected to the server, and all the operation we could have done directly on the Raspberry Pi, we can do from the any machine, because we are connecting Raspberry Pi. We are not connected to Raspberry Pi, we are connecting to the MongoDB on the Raspberry Pi. The process I mentioned here in this video is, if you go to online resources, it will not work. You have to do some R&D and you have to do some trial and error, and that way you will be able to install MongoDB completely. And that's what I did. This whole process I did not record it because this is frustrating and you don't know what is going on. Then you have to do research and whole the process you have to do. So I did not record whole process, but the precise process and the steps to install the MongoDB on Raspberry Pi. So if you go through this process, you're definitely able to install the Raspberry Pi, and it will be working one time. If you like this video, please share this video and give your comment and also subscribe. It will help channel to grow, and I would be able to, it will inspire me to put the more content like this. And in future I'm going to create a blog of my development, and if you're interested, please subscribe the channel and click on notification icon. Thank you.